Say, how many of you like the ocean? Show of hands. It's pretty wet. Huh? Well, how many of you like fishing? That's right, nobody. Because fishing is boring.
Well, I don't know, Rabbit. It can be relaxing for some people.
But how many of you like fighting skeleton pirates on the back of killer whales? Ah, well, I know a guy who does that for a living.
Oh, is it me?
No, it's not you, John. You don't have your sea legs for such an endeavor. Gotta trade in those bee legs.
That was a pun.
That was a pun. It's only the greatest sailor that ever set sail, Captain Albert Alexander. You have no idea who he is, do you? Well, let me explain. He's kind of like if you took the Hulk and the Spider-Man and somehow mutated them together into one entity.
Oh, well, I love the amazing, incredible Spider-Hulk.
I didn't know you could do that.
Yeah, it's called a hybrid.
Well, Captain Albert Alexander would totally beat that guy in an arm wrestling match. Yeah.
Say what?
I'm just saying.
Say what?
I'm just saying.
Say what?
When he was a boy, he wanted to play down by the sea. At age 13, every day after school, he would always sail around the lake. All the people would stand and stare as he sailed around with precision and care. His bicolor hat and the way he would stand, he looked just like a Navy man. All the townsfolk would gather and say and sing away, Captain Albert Alexander, you'll be a brave seafarer someday. Puppet Captain Albert Alexander, you'll go down in the waves. By age 24, he'd left the shore and was sailing for the Queen. On a dark, starry night, Abbott awoke to the sound of his captain screaming as he was drowned. The Navy crew was taking a lick. A pirate had invaded the ship. But Albert, with one aimed harpoon, ignited their rum with a spark, and soon flames drove the pirates away. The Navy sang, Captain Albert Alexander saved his crew from pirate slaughter. But that Captain Albert Alexander, he'll go down in the water. Now everyone dance, 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 la da 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 da, la da 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 da. 20 some odd years later, on a ship with Sea Slater, he sailed into a mass of blubber. Gazing up to the sky stood a large walrus. That was 100 stories high. It meant no harm. The walrus was in a great deal of pain. It suffered from a tusk with tooth decay. Albert threw his anchor around its tusk. With a little bit of pulling, it was out by dusk. The walrus thanked Albert and sang as it sailed away. Captain Albert Alexander, friend to sea urchin and the me. But that Captain Albert Alexander, he'll go down in the sea. At a ripe old age, lightning struck from the sky and split Albert's vessel in two. 100 men fled for their lives on rafts across the ocean blue. Halbert stood at the stern of his ship. A giant octopus had him in its grip. A vortex of spiraling death below ripped. And sharks and electric eels all made the trip to see Albert sink to the bottom of the sea. Just before he went down, he called out to his crew.
It's obvious that my time has come. I'll let this ending ensue. I've lived an exciting nautical life, it would seem, and there's no better end than a death by the sea.
His crew say,
Captain Albert
Alexander,
he went
down
in the sea. But that Captain Albert
Alexander,
he'll go down in his story.
John, don't cry. It's just a story.
Huh?
A real story. That Captain Albert Alexander,
he went down.